गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन. आर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज फोर्स. ओके, सो यू विल स्टडी फ्यू थिंग्स फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर. फर्स्ट थिंग इज फोर्स. व्हेन यू अप्लाई इट ऑन अ रिजिड बॉडी, इट शोज टू टाइप्स ऑफ मोशन. ओके, वन इज लीनियर और ट्रांसलेशनल मोशन एंड वन इज रोटेशनल मोशन. वॉट इज लीनियर मोशन? When the body moves in a straight line, it's called as linear motion. And what is rotational motion? When a body rotates, moves round and round about a fixed point. Okay, that fixed point is usually called as pivot, like this. There is a fixed point. You are applying the force straight, but the body will not move straight. The body, since it is fixed at the center, it will go round and round. So you will see that even though you are applying the force straight, the body rotates. Okay, this turning effect of force and the motion of the body is in rotational motion. Okay, here in this you will see that when you apply the force, the ball will move forward in the direction of force. But here when you apply the force forward, the ball will rotate about an axis because the ball is fixed at the center. That's why, as it is fixed at the center, it cannot move forward like this, but it will start to rotate. Okay, if we apply force on a rigid body pivoted at the center, usually it turns. Okay, that force is unable to produce a linear motion in its direction. Understood? Even though you are applying the force straight, it will not produce a linear motion. The body will not move forward in the direction of force. It will always tend to rotate, okay, in another direction. So the body is actually undergoing a action of torque. Okay, torque means the turning effect of force. Though you are applying the force straight, but the body is turning. Why the body is turning or rotating? Because you have a fixed point here. Okay, you have a pivot here at its center. So that's why the body is rotating, and this rotation is called as turning effect of force. What are the factors affecting the turning effect of force? There are two factors. One is the magnitude of force applied, and next is the perpendicular distance of the line of action of force from the axis of rotation. Means the distance between line of action, means the point where you are applying the force, okay, and the perpendicular distance, this is the perpendicular distance, AP is the perpendicular distance, and the magnitude of force is, say, F is the magnitude of force. Okay, not AP, OP. I think A is the point where you are applying the force. Okay, see here it is written. If the force is applied horizontally on the body with its line of action in the direction AP. So AP is the line of action, and O is the point, pivot point. So distance between AP and O is OP, fine. So OP is the perpendicular distance. We need the perpendicular distance between the line of action of force and the pivot point. Okay, so that distance into the magnitude of force will give you the moment of force. Another name of moment of force is torque. We'll see here. The moment of force or torque is equal to the product of these two factors. Okay, product of magnitude of force applied and perpendicular distance of line of action of force from the axis of rotation. So when you multiply these two, the factors that is affecting the turning of a body, when you multiply these two, the product of these two will give you the measure for torque. Okay, there is a small note here. Notice means if we want the turning effect to be more, then the magnitude of force should be more. Okay, see, for producing maximum turning effect, maximum torque, suppose you want the body to rotate fast, okay, so for that, what do we need? We need to apply the force also maximum. See, distance of line, the force from the axis of rotation is maximum. The perpendicular distance also is maximum, so that the force may provide maximum torque. Okay, so we need moment of force is equals to F into S. S means the distance. So if force is more, moment of force will be also more, torque will be more. And if the perpendicular distance is more, then also force will be, then also torque will be more. Okay, so it depends upon both the two factors. Both the two factors affects the turning effect of the body. More force, more will be the torque. More the perpendicular distance of force from the point O, more will be the torque. Now, what are the two units? We know that we have SI unit and CGS unit. SI unit is just a unit of force, that is Newton, and unit of distance is meter. So, Newton meter. Okay. Similarly, CGS unit is dyne centimeter. And the relation is 1 Newton meter equals to 10 to the power 7 dyne centimeter. Now, there are two directions. Whenever we talk about moment as it is going around, there are two directions. One is clockwise and anticlockwise. Conventionally, if the effect of a body is to turn in clockwise, anticlockwise, the moment of force is called anticlockwise moment. And it is taken positive. We have studied about all these things in class 8. Right? So, when the body is moving in anticlockwise direction, the moment of force is anticlockwise moment. And it is taken positive. Remember this. Here also it is written. Anticlockwise moment, this direction is taken positive. Okay. Similarly, if the effect on the body is to turn it clockwise, the moment of force is called clockwise moment and it is taken negative. The moment of force is a vector quantity. Remember that. And the direction of anticlockwise moment is along the axis of rotation outwards. Anticlockwise moment is outwards. And clockwise moment is inwards. So, that's why, you know, when we turn a knob clockwise, it goes inside. When you tighten something, correct? When you tighten the cap of any bottle, when you tighten it, always it goes down, it goes inwards. When you move it in anticlockwise direction, it moves outwards. So always clockwise moment is inwards and anticlockwise moment is outwards. To open something, we used to do anticlockwise moment. Yes or no? So that's why, just remember that outwards, inwards, like you're opening and closing a tap or a screw. Okay, just remember like that. On applying the force on a pivoted body, its direction of rotation depends on the point of application of force, means the point where you are applying the force, and the direction of force, okay, in which direction you are moving. By changing the point of application of force, figure 1.4a shows the anticlockwise and clockwise moment produced in a disc pivoted at its center by changing the point of application of force from point A to B. Okay, that means at this point you are applying the force at A, and then next you are applying the force at B. So when you are applying the force at the point A, it is moving in this direction, it is moving in anticlockwise direction. But when you are applying the force here at the point B, it is starting to move like this. So really it depends where you are applying the force. If your application of force, the point of application of force is different, then your moment also will be different. Okay, the direction of the force also will be different. Here see, at the point A, when you are applying, it's going in this direction. But when you are applying it, the force at the point B, it is moving in clockwise direction. So when we change the point of application of force, the direction changes. Okay. Next is, when we change the direction of force, see, you are changing the direction. First you are applying the direction in this way. That time also it is going anticlockwise. When you are applying the direction in the downward direction, this is upward direction, this is downward direction, then it goes in clockwise direction. Okay, so when we change the direction of force, like figure 1.4b, it shows anticlockwise and clockwise moment produced on a pivoted axle by changing the direction of force at free end of the axle. At the free end of the axle, when you change the direction of force, that time also the moment will be different, the torque will be different. Common examples of moment of force. Very simple, when you open or shut a door, we apply force. Where do we apply force? Tell me. Where, suppose this is the door. This is the door. We will never apply force near to the hinge. This is the hinge, you say. Okay? So, if you consider this as a hinge and you turn the door, you will never turn the door touching here. You will never push the door like this. Like this. It will take more force. Whereas if you just take the door just at the end, okay, what happens is it is more easier, okay, because when the distance of the point of application of force is more from the pivot, okay, the distance is more, then the torque will be more, then it is more easy. When in order to close and open the door or window, you just try closing the door or window from near the pivot point and from far the pivot point. Okay, you will find out the difference. See here, you always apply the point here. That's why we keep handles also in the edge of the door, away from the hinge. Okay, we never make a hinge in the middle or near the we never put a handle near the hinge or in the middle. We always fix a handle at the other end, away from the hinge, the opposite side of the hinge, okay, so that it is easy for us, and with less force we could, you know, with a minimum force we could just have a turning effect on the door. Okay, next is just remember, go through these points. There is a point here. Thus, the handle piece provided near the free end of the door so that smaller force at larger perpendicular distance from the hinges produces the moment of force required to open or shut the door. Yes? You know, when you apply the force at the near the hinge, large force is required to have the same turning effect of force. Okay? As that of the one which where you are holding at the far end here. That means yat dharatke yat easy hobo. Yat dhorile yar pra push korile saba besi force lagibo. Kintu yar komti force ate door to turn hoye jabo. Just remember that. Next is the upper circular stone of a hand floor grinder is provided with a handle near its rim. That is at the maximum distance from the center, so that it can easily be rotated about the iron pivot at its center by applying a small force at the handle. Okay, so here also you have a hand floor where you have a circular stone above. Okay, so that circular stone is going to be a grinder, and that grinder has a handle near the rim. Okay, so that handle it is at a maximum distance. It is placed at a maximum distance from the center or from the pivot, so that when you rotate it, hand grinder, when you rotate it, it is easy to rotate. From near it is far, but near it is hard, but from far it is easy to rotate the iron grinder. Okay, around, rotated above the iron pivot at its center. It is not an iron grinder, but a stone grinder which you are using to grind something. Okay, so when you are grinding like this, actually it is rotating you because it is pivoted at the center with the iron pivot. Okay, so it is very easy because we have the handle at the end, at the far end. Because we have the handle at the far end, a small force is enough, sufficient to move. For turning a steering wheel, a force is applied tangentially on the rim of the wheel. It is not applied in middle, it is applied on the rim. The sense of rotation of wheel is changed by changing the point of application of force without changing the direction of force. Okay, so we are not changing the direction of force, but we are changing the application of force. So remember, sometimes the driver has to move in this direction, sometimes in the right direction. So in whichever direction you are changing the, you are applying the force, in that direction it is getting rotated. Okay, so see, when force F is applied at the point A, just like this diagram, when it is applied at the point A, it is moving in the anticlockwise direction. When it is applied at point B, it is moving in clockwise direction. So it will move in clockwise direction in order to move the car towards the right, and it will move in anticlockwise direction in order to move the car towards the left. In a bicycle, to turn the rear wheel anticlockwise, a small force is applied on the foot pedal of a tooted wheel of size bigger than the rear wheel, so that the perpendicular distance of the point of application of force from the axle of the wheel is large. The toothed wheel is joined to the rear wheel by a chain through the tooth. So when you see a bicycle, even there you have two wheels. Okay, I mean, here you have one wheel and axle. This is also one wheel and axle, in which the axle is connected to the bigger wheel has here connected to the foot pedal, and this axle wheel is connected to the wheel of the cycle. Okay. Now this wheel is connected to the cycle, so when this wheel moves, okay, see here, when you are applying the foot pedal in the downward direction, the full thing will move like this. When you apply the foot pedal, now sometimes it this is actually rotatable. So when you are keeping it in this direction, applying the force in this direction, it will move forward. Okay, in this we could see that it is moving backwards. So when it is moving backwards, that time you will see that this axle also starts moving in the same direction. Okay, in the anti-clockwise direction. The anti-clockwise direction. Fine. So when it is driven like this, the whole cycle moves. The toothed wheel is joined to the rear wheel by a chain through the tooth. Like that, you have many examples. Spanner example is also there. See, you are applying the force at this end. Why the spanner's handle is long? The longer the handle, the more easier it is to, you know, tighten or loosen a screw or a nut bolt. It's very easy using a spanner. So when you use a spanner, you apply the force at this point, which is far from the pivot point. When the distance is large, torque is more. So with the less force, you are able to you can produce the turning effect, and you can open or close a nut. When you are turning it clockwise, it is getting tightened, because we know that it moves inwards. When you are moving it in the anticlockwise direction, it is getting loosened. Okay. Next is a jack screw used to lift a heavy load such as a vehicle. That jack screw also has a long arm. So that, why we have long arm? Always remember long arm, long handle. It is because in order to increase the perpendicular distance. When we increase the perpendicular distance, then the force required to bring that turning effect will be very less. So with less effort, you can do the work. Okay. So from all the above examples, here also less effort is required to rotate it, to raise or lower the jack. Okay. Conclusion. From the above examples, we conclude that the turning effect, turning of a body about an axis, depends on two things. One is magnitude of force, and another is it depends on the perpendicular distance of the line of action of the applied force from the axis of rotation. This is the perpendicular distance of a spanner, perpendicular distance of a jack screw, perpendicular distance. This one is the perpendicular distance from the handle from the hinge. Okay, perpendicular distance. All are, both are important. The force applied and the perpendicular distance. So, go through these points. We'll continue in the next part.